This is the new U7 Pro wall, and it has a secret power. That secret power is invisibility. That's right, this is the first access point that I'm aware of that is specifically designed to disappear into its surroundings with a flush mount and a paintable cover. Sound interesting? Let's take a closer look. The friendly technicians at Rogue Support are experts at helping you get the most out of your wireless networks. Whether you're looking for design, equipment selection, configuration, or troubleshooting, Rogue Support has got you covered. Simply open up a ticket on the web at rogue.support and you'll be well on your way to having full wireless coverage in that back bathroom that's always super spotty. And you don't pay anything until your ticket is resolved. Give it a shot, you won't be disappointed. The U7 Pro Wall is the latest Wi-Fi 7 access point from Ubiquiti, and it has an option that we've never seen before. I mean, we have already seen a couple of generations of in-wall access points, but we've never before seen one that's actually designed to be in the wall, as in almost completely flush mount. When using the flush mount adapter, this access point sticks out only about a half an inch, or just over 1 centimeter from the wall. And the cover is paintable, so no matter what color your walls are, you can make this access point almost invisible. This is a new concept in that when it comes to design, wireless access points are typically an afterthought. I mean, the only place that I've ever really been where I wasn't able to spot any access points was Disneyland, right? And the Disneyland Imagineers are the type to take everything into consideration so that the immersive experience for the guests isn't interrupted. With the U7 Pro Wall, home builders, architects, and interior designers can incorporate these access points into their designs ahead of time, which is going to make the final product that much more aesthetically pleasing. So let's talk about the mounting options first. The MSRP of the U7 Pro Wall is $199, and out of the box, it can mount directly on the wall or onto a single gang electrical box, just like any of the other in-wall access points we've seen before. The flush mount accessory with the paintable cover is an additional $39, and it works almost like mounting a regular in-wall, except you cut the hole a little bit bigger and then install the flush mount accessory instead of that single gang electrical box. The PoE cable comes up through the back and the U7 Pro Wall snaps right into place. There's also a $39 desk mount accessory if you want to go that route. The U7 Pro Wall is a Wi-Fi 7 access point with 2x2 MIMO across all three wireless bands. That's 2.4 GHz, 5 GHz, and 6 GHz. In the 6 GHz spectrum, or when you're using Wi-Fi 7, you can set the channel width all the way up to 320 MHz for some seriously fast wireless speeds. The U7 Pro Wall can be powered up by PoE Plus, and it has a 2.5 gigabit RJ45 Ethernet port on the bottom. Now, I know what you're thinking. All of the previous in-wall models have had switch ports and PoE pass-through on the bottom of the access point. But remember, the U7 Pro Wall is designed to be flush mount inside of a wall, where extra switch ports aren't going to be very useful. Now that being said though, Ubiquiti told me there is a more traditional U7 in-wall access point in the works that does have those extra switch ports on the bottom. I don't have any additional information or ETA about that other U7 in-wall access point, but you know, even if I did know, I'm under NDA with Ubiquiti, so if I told you, I'd have to kill you. The U7 Pro Wall supports over 300 concurrent clients, and it has a maximum throughput rate of just over 5.7 gigabits per second when using it with Wi-Fi 7 devices. But admittedly, those measurements are always a bit misleading in that what they're doing there is adding the total potential upload and download speeds together. So realistically, you'd likely see speeds upwards of like 1.8 to 2 gigabits upload and download in a perfect environment when you're using the maximum 320 megahertz channel width and a Wi-Fi 7 capable testing device. In fact, let's go ahead and test it out now. For my testing setup, I have a Google Pixel 8 that's running Wi-Fi 7 and it's wirelessly connected over to the U7 Pro Wall. I've configured the U7 Pro Wall with a 320 megahertz channel width in the Wi-Fi 7 band, and it's set to a channel that I know is not going to interfere with anything else that I have running around my house. The U7 Pro Wall is 2.5 gigabit connected into a 24 port Pro Max PoE switch, and also plugged into that same PoE switch with a 2.5 gigabit port is my Mac Mini M2 that has a 10 gigabit NIC and it's running open speed test. All right, so kind of get an idea of the full picture of what I'm working with here. Let me refresh this page and let's run our open speed test now. This, of course, is a perfect environment, right? I've got no interference. I've got the testing device right next to the U7 Pro wall, so we'll see what kind of speeds we can get. Okay, so test number one, we ended up with 1600 down by 2100 up. All right, let's try that one more time. In fact, this time I'm gonna put them a little bit further apart here. Not by much, but we'll just sort of separate them out just a bit. And let's run it again. All right, so second time we got almost the same result. We got 1560 on the download and 1973 on the upload. All right, heat-wise, this thing is not getting too terribly hot. I've certainly felt hotter access points in my day. So using my little heat gun here, I'm measuring 99 degrees Fahrenheit on the back, which is 37 degrees Celsius, and 113.8 degrees on the front, which is 45.8 degrees Celsius. Certainly not so hot that I would have a problem sticking this inside my wall. So what do I think about the U7 Pro wall? I actually think it's pretty cool. I think installers especially are gonna love these things because it looks so great for their clients once the install is done. I also really like that they're doing these paintable covers instead of like those, you know, preset skins that we've had in the past. So, you know, now rather than being stuck with just a handful of different covers, you've basically got unlimited options. Also, I'm not sure if you guys saw it or not, but they did just come out with a paintable cover for the U7 Pro as well. So Ubiquiti shows once again that they're actually thinking about how these access points can be and should be used out in the real world. And they're trying new stuff, right? While still providing alternatives like the more traditional U7 in-wall that's coming out in the future. The true test is seeing how long it takes for other companies to catch up. Like, how long do you think it's gonna be before TP-Link or someone else comes out with a flush mount access point that has a paintable cover? My guess is that we'll probably start seeing copycats hit the market by the end of the year. Okay, so let me know what you think about the new U7 Pro wall down in the comments, and if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my past review of the original U7 Pro access point from Ubiquiti, and the bottom video is my overview of the new 16-port Pro Max PoE switch with Ether lighting.